I couldn't make it all out, that is, the details, but I got the general idea, and enough of it, too, to be ashamed. It was not fair to spring those 19th-century technicalities upon the untutored infant of the 6th, and then rail at her because she couldn't get their drift. And when she was making the honest, best drive at it, she could, too, and no fault of hers that she couldn't fetch the home plate. And so I apologized. Then we meandered pleasantly away toward the hermit holes in sociable converse together, and better friends than ever. I was gradually coming to have a mysterious and shuddery reverence for this girl. Nowadays, whenever she pulled out from the station and got her train fairly started on one of those horizonless transcontinental sentences of hers, it was borne in upon me that I was standing in the awful presence of the mother of the German language. I was so impressed with this that sometimes when she began to empty one of these sentences on me, I unconsciously took the very attitude of reverence and stood uncovered. And if words had been water, I had been drowned, sure. She had exactly the German way. Whatever was in her mind to be delivered, whether a mere remark or a sermon or a cyclopedia or the history of a war, she would get it into a single sentence or die. Whenever the literary German dives into a sentence, that is the last you are going to see of him till he emerges on the other side of his Atlantic with his verb in his mouth. We drifted from hermit to hermit all the afternoon. It was a most strange menagerie. The chief emulation among them seemed to be to see which could manage to be the uncleanest and most prosperous with vermin. Their manner and attitudes were the last expression of complacent self-righteousness. It was one anchorite's pride to lie naked in the mud and let the insects bite him and blister him unmolested. It was another's to lean against a rock all day long, conspicuous to the admiration of the throng of pilgrims, and pray. It was another's to go naked and crawl around on all fours. It was another's to drag about with him, year in and year out, 80 pounds of iron. It was another's to never lie down when he slept, but to stand among the thorn bushes and snore when there were pilgrims around to look. A woman who had the white hair of age and no other apparel was black from crown to heel with 47 years of holy abstinence from water.